9 to 31.
In Acts chapter 3 verse 19, it talks about restoration. Are your Bibles open? Okay, you read alongside with me. What's the first word there? Repent ye therefore and be converted, so that your sins may be blotted out. Until times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. And he shall send Jesus Christ. Let me read the verse. So you can open that. Acts 3, 19 to 21. And he shall send Jesus Christ, which before was preached unto you. So this is Jesus Christ. When Peter talked about sending Jesus Christ, is that the first coming or second coming?
Second coming.
No, it's the second coming, which was preached, already preached. So if Jesus Christ before was already preached, he already died, he was buried and resurrected already. So when Peter talked about sending Jesus Christ, it's the second coming. So you can imagine, if this is the church ages, there are seven church ages, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it's the seventh. He shall send Jesus Christ. How is he going to send? He's going to send it back to earth again. What's the next verse? Whom heaven must receive. Mark it down in your Bible. Whom heaven must receive. So he is up there in heaven. Our mediator. Whom heaven must receive until. So there is a time period. This is the period of until. The times of restitution of all things. So, whom heaven must receive until. So until that time, there is a restoration, he will come back again. And what is supposed to be restored? Verse 22, all things. Whatsoever things he said to you is the will of God. It's revelation. Of course, there are some commentators that say this is about Israel. I'm not against that. You can apply it to the time of Adamic restoration. Because after that, it's the millennium and the eternal age. So, but let's talk about restoration within the church age. There is an apostasy in the church age, and there is a restoration in the church age. And we have to follow on through that restoration so that we can get what this is the seventh seal, what is the exact master key so that you will receive the Holy Ghost. You will follow on through God's progressive revelation. You know what God is doing at the present truth. Not just the past, not just the future, but you know what He's going to do, the present truth. Every age, He has a master key. In every age, He builds His house on the rock. And how is that house being built? How do you apply Acts 2:38 repentance in our lives? That's what I add the term, Berean repentance. That's how you manifest with the word. I'm going to show you the Nicolaitan spirit also that's plaguing all churches today. This Nicolaitan spirit that's plaguing all churches today, these are schisms, these are close-mindedness, these are partisanships. These are judgmental spirits. These are prejudices. And there are many, shall say, dogmatic teachings that was inherited from the denominations. Teachings of men, still. We have Babylonian garments we have to cast away. Okay, let's go back here. So, Jesus Christ is in heaven, mediating for us, which before was preached unto you. Whom heaven must receive, and he will send Jesus Christ. Now, what is this restitution? So, So, let me enumerate what I mentioned a while ago, if you take note. The restitution is, number one, some have applied it to Israel. Some have applied it to Adamic restoration, after the, even before the fall. But what we're going to talk about is church age, restoration within the church. In lieu with this, that could connect all these three, we could use the promise given in 70 weeks of Daniel. Maybe we could take a peek. Let's open up. Daniel chapter 9, verse 24. Let's open up. There are sixfold purposes mentioned there. The sixfold purposes mentioned there, it seems like it's about Israel, but if you understand carefully, it does not only involve Israel, it involves the church. Not only involves the church, it involves the whole world. So all these things will be involved. So please open up, please read for us. Daniel chapter 9, verse 24. Who can read for us? 70 weeks are given unto you. Daniel is in the middle, before Hosea, after Hosea. Okay, sister, Eric. Who has the Bible? Okay lang English. Wala lang Tagalog, okay lang English.
77 are decreed for your people and your holy city to finish transgression, to put an end of to sin, to atone for wickedness, to bring in everlasting righteousness, to seal up visions and prophecy, and to anoint the most holy.
Now understand little by little. It's about the city. It's about Israel. But later he talks about finish the transgression. He talks about make reconciliation for iniquity, make an end for sins, to anoint the most holy, to seal up the vision and prophecy. Now, when you talk about, when Daniel was reading this, he was being answered with regards to Israel. To make an end of sins, to finish the transgression. And literally did he realize, it's not just Israel's transgression that will be ended. It will be the whole world. And before it will be ushered in, the church will come in. Jesus Christ will come in, the church will come in. And the church and Israel will go parallel side by side up to the end. There is what we call the last week of Daniel here. 7-year tribulation period. The last week of Daniel.